Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you the overloading stored procedure names in the Snowflake stored procedure. This is the 13th video from Snowflake stored procedures playlist. So what is the overloading? So overloading is nothing but stored procedures that have the same names but different number of arguments called the overloading. Let's get start demo. So let me set the context. Overloading the stored procedure names. First, as part of this demo, let me create two stored procedures that have the same names but different number of arguments. Create or replace procedure stproc1 evaluate float underscore param1, data type is the float, returns string, language Java script, yes, JavaScript delimiter $, here simply I am returning whatever that parameter. So to use the parameter, you have to pass the uppercase inside the body param one $$ and let me compile the create this procedure. A procedure has been created. Now with the same name I'm going to create another parameter with two different with two arguments, create or replace procedure stproc1 float underscore param1 data type float underscore param two data type float, returns string, language JavaScript, as $$ is the JavaScript delimiter. To here this time return float underscore param1 plus just summation of two parameters. So float underscore param parameter 2 and so let me create this procedure also with the same name. So function stproc1 successfully created. Now we have created two procedures with same name but different parameters. Now let me call the, now what I am going to do, call the procedure twice. First time pass the float and second time pass the varchar. No, sorry, let me call this procedure. So what I am going to call procedure name stproc1. Here I am going to just roll number and then call. See, expected output would be return string 12 only. So now what I am going to do, let me call two parameters 12, 30. Now what would be the output? Summation means 25. Okay, done. Now what I am going to do, suppose if you call stproc1 with 12.12 plus, this time I am passing the second parameter as the string. Okay, so what I will do, 12 same inputs only, but second parameter I am passing as a string, but here number only. So what it will have, this will convert auto typecasting, auto converting, because 13 is the number only. So even though if you pass as a string inside, then it will convert auto string. But this time what I am going to do here, if you see, now I am passing the varchar. Okay, so like a string, two. So this time we'll see the output. So numeric value 2 is not recognized. That means the auto casting didn't happen, because we cannot convert a actual string into a float. But number you can convert, even though number is, if you pass as a string, string means inside, if you keep that number inside the single quote, then it will consider as a string, but it will automatically convert. So typecasting, or else what you can do, you can stproc 1 12 :: this is the typecasting. So instead of using the cast, you can use the :: to float. So like that also you can call your procedure. See, output would be same. Now what I am going to do, so this is the, what I explained, this one varchar is converted to a float and the output from the each call is identical. Okay, now what I am going to do next time, create a overload stored procedure that takes the varchar parameter. Now I am going to create a parameter called the varchar with the same name only, or different, whatever it may be. So let me take create or replace add underscore some value. So add underscore pi value. Okay, pi parameter name. This time I will create one with the float and another one with the varchar. Okay, so parameter name float underscore param 1, data type float, returns string, or you can mention string, and language JavaScript as $ return float. What is that one? A parameter float float underscore TARA param 1 plus .14 14 167, like that. Okay, so this is the value, and then close this one. Okay, now let me compile this one, add pi. Okay, this is the another add underscore. Okay, procedure keyword I missed, procedure. Yeah, okay, function add underscore pi successfully created. Now I am going to create an same procedure with the different parameter. So create or replace procedure add underscore pi, this time use the varchar. Okay, so varchar underscore param 1 varchar, so in that case string. Okay, string, or here also let me give the string only, string. You can pass the varchar also. So for our understand, let me use the varchar only. So varchar here also, varchar returns string language JavaScript as $ is the delimiter, JavaScript delimiter. Now return, what is that one? Return this time varchar underscore param, param 1 plus what is the value we are going to, yeah, this is the, okay, now going to end. Let me, okay, function here. Now let me call the this one, call add underscore py. So now let me, first time I created with the float number, so let me add the 2.2 value, 2 only. So now what would be the output? So it added, see, it's not, didn't add this one. See, 23. What happened here? See, it basically concatenated. Let me do one more thing. Suppose it didn't, I mean, actually summation didn't happen, just concatenation. If I mention space here in the string, so we can understand that concatenation how. Let me recompile again. Now add two. See, it's just concatenated. 2, 3, 5. Now what I am going to do, let me pass the string. Second parameter is this, I mean, another one is the string. So here, two. See, 2, 3.1. So this is the one way. And also what I can do, instead of keeping this one, this time what I'm going to change this one. Instead of keeping in the string, directly I'm putting as a number. Then we'll see how is going to behavior, what is the behavior. Okay, let me recompile the same procedure here. I'm just change the inside that content and compile. Okay, and now let me call this same. See, this time it added. So okay, one case. Now another case, let me pass this string. Okay, here string I am passing the 2 only. Okay, see, when I pass the float, okay, output, expected output, we saw the expected output. Now let me see this one. In this case, this is a string. Here, even though that is the converted string, so it is just concatenated. It has a concatenated. Now what I am going to do to avoid this problem, so auto conversion. So this one colon colon float, then output, we'll see the what would be the output. Sorry, here float. Yeah, now let me see here. Once typecasting happened, then summation, actual summation adding happened over here. If you don't convert that one, it will consider as a string, even though it is a number string, and concatenating to existing string. Call add underscore py. So here let me tw2. Okay, now we will see. Yeah, so concatenation. Okay, this is the output. Now let me see one more thing. Select star from information underscore schema, schema dot procedures. We have a metadata view name is the procedures, 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 where procedure, procedure name like add underscore 5, or we know the add underscore 5 VI pi. Let me execute this one. We'll see the how internally stored this one procedure name with the procedure with the different arguments. So if you see here, the database name is the demo underscore db schema, okay, public, and procedure name. See, we have a two entries here, two procedures, okay, with the same name, and procedure owner is the account admin. Now if you see here, argument signature, we have created a same procedure with different parameters. So for the first time, we have created a float underscore parameter, and type is the float, and varchar param 1 varchar with the different data type. So this is the data type is nothing but a return type, return string. Both cases we use the string. So you can change also that one, you can also change that one. So this is the how you are going to check the details from the metadata. See, this is the body, inside that body, okay, same, and then created. Now what I am going to do, I will just let me change the return type, okay, return string here, return string not here, you can change here also. Let me do the first, okay, first procedure. For that, before changing this one, let me, what is that procedure? ST proc, ST percentile PRO, okay. See, this is also two created with the overloading with the same name with different number of, see, this time float parameter float and float parameter two parameters. Now what I am going to do, we can not only parameters, different parameters, you can change the data returns also. Here first case, what I will do, I am just number, let me put the number, okay, num, instead of number we cannot use float, let me put the float, 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 and here let I will keep the string only. So let me recompile this procedure, and let me recompile this procedure, and let, okay, sorry, not this one, not this one, yeah, for these procedures, okay, yeah, float, yeah, float, recompile. Now let me, this one as it is, I am going to keep as it is. Now let me execute this one. We didn't see any output. See, number, this is the format change from string to, that's why output was in the right side, extremely light right side, and this time we will see the left side because string. But even though it converted, I mean added these two parameters 25, but output would be the type is the varchar instead of number. That is the difference. Now what I will see the metadata information for this one. See, output would be here, data type earlier it was same, now data type is the float, and for second one is the varchar only, okay. That is all about overloading Snowflake stored procedure with same name and different parameters. Thanks for watching video, and if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, and don't forget to click on bell icon for the notifications. Please share it and like it. Thank you once again for watching my video.